In a previous video designed to help you with AM2, AM2S and AM2E, your end point assessment for apprentice electricians, I suggested that you are required to disconnect the protective bonding conductor at both ends, the MET, and where it's connected, say, to the gas and water pipes in order to prove its continuity and remove parallel earth paths. And I produced this video just here. However, it's come to my attention that you don't. The first part of the assessment, which is your install, you can just test it as I've shown previously on the channel, and I'll leave a link for that in the eye above my head and in the description below so you can check out that video. We disconnect it from the MET, use our long wandering lead and check it against the actual connection and the pipe in order to prove continuity. However, it would be advantageous to disconnect it at both ends from the MET and from the pipe work so you're testing just the cable. When you do the fault finding element of AM2, AM2S and AM2E in order to find that fault. So in this video, I'm going to go through pictorially how to carry out the protective bonding conductor test, as well as how to do it when you're looking for the fault finding element and prove to you how we can find that broken conductor by disconnecting both ends. If you want to skip to any part of the video, please check out the timestamps. They're in the description below, or you can click on the screen so you can jump forward if you're just interested in that element, which is the fault finding. Let's go to the desk and have a look at what I've got set up. I'm going to show pictorially what you got your end point assessment. I've drawn here the three-phase distribution board. I've got a separate MET main earthing terminal, as you will have on your rig, and you will install a new circuit for the protective bonding to the water and to the gas. And I've simulated them coming in metal, so this makes these extraneous conductive parts. We need to test this protective bonding conductor, and I've done that many times on the channel before, and I said I'll leave that in the description in the eye above my head. But you've also got to remember that you must isolate and lock off the distribution board. And again, I've shown that, I'll leave it above my head and in the description, how to carry out the safe isolation when you've got a three-phase distribution board. So once we're safely isolated, we can start thinking about disconnecting our protective bonding conductors and carrying out the tests. Having set up my multifunctional tester to ohms, removed the resistance of the lead, we're ready to carry out the test. So I've simulated here, obviously, a disconnected from the MET. I've disconnected my water protective bonding conductor, and I'm going to test from the disconnected end to the actual connection on the bonding clamp and then to the water pipe. And I'm going to record the highest of those two readings. So if I take my leads, I'm going to bring my lead out to my disconnected protective bonding conductor. I've got it here slightly larger. You can see I've removed it from the MET in order to make an electrical connection. And then my second lead goes on to the connection on the clamp. So where we've made the connection onto the clamp, and we measure that resistance. So we're measuring the resistance of the protective bonding conductor. However, I like us to measure not just to the clamp, but also to the pipe. This pipe needs to prove that it's got an electrical connection. Imagine if the clamp went around paint or say tarnished or corroded elements of the pipe work, you might not have a very good electrical connection onto the copper pipe itself. So I need to prove it onto the pipe. So what I'd end up doing is leaving my lead connected to my disconnected protective bonding conductor and move my lead off the actual clamp and onto the pipe in order to make that test, record that reading. So that would prove that the protective bonding conductor newly installed is continuous. In other words, we measure its resistance in ohms, and I measure it to both the actual clamp and pipe work in order to prove it's electrically connected. And I can reconnect it into the MET and work with the gas one next. So I've now disconnected the protective bonding conductor that I know goes to my gas. Remember, I've installed these myself, and you can see here clearly it's disconnected from the MET. You could leave them both out at this stage. I've put one back. You don't have to put it back, but they will need to go back in at some point. Exactly the same process. One of my leads comes onto the disconnected protective bonding conductor for the gas, and then the other one goes onto the clamp there for the gas. So we can prove that that conductor is continuous. We measure its resistance. And likewise, we do exactly the same as we did before. We leave our test lead on the disconnected one for the gas, and then we make a connection onto the gas pipe to prove that the clamp makes a good electrical connection to the metal work of that pipe. So that would be that one. The next one's interesting because this is now where we're thinking about the fault finding in the next part of the video. Let's think about the fault finding element of your endpoint assessment and think about maybe if there was a broken protective bonding conductor. So what I've got here is I've got my protective bonding conductor to one pipe, don't know what pipe it is, and I've got my protective bonding conductor to another pipe. Now the likelihood is you'll only see this element here at one end, so you'll see where they're connected to the pipework, and you'll have access to the MET in order to disconnect the protective bonding conductor under test. You'll be set a scenario, but let's think about what could happen when you do this test if you do disconnect them one at a time from the MET, okay, and don't disconnect them from both ends. So in the first case, I've disconnected one of the protective bonding conductors from the MET. I don't know which one it is because obviously I've not installed these and I don't know where they go and I can't see the run. So I've disconnected one of them. So we'll put one of our leads onto that, onto the protective bonding conductor disconnected. And then I'm going to put my other lead, not knowing which end it is, onto this clamp here. Okay, and then we'll see if we think we'll get a reading. So we come onto here, onto the clamp. So now I measure the resistance that goes down this conductor here and disappears. It goes into this pipe work, and let's say that this is, I don't know, the water pipe, and the water and gas are connected together. We know at boilers and places like that. So the pipe work is connected together. Would I get a reading? So let's work that out. So I measure the resistance down this conductor, down here, okay, to here. Okay, I get my circuit. So I get a path through there, yet the protective bonding conductor actually feeding this pipework is broken. And I've picked up the parallel earth path here. Now it could have been, you could have been lucky, couldn't you? You could have tested to that one first and then test disconnected, and we'll look at that in a second. And you might have stumbled across it, but look at that. How unlucky have you been? Disconnected one of the protective bonding conductors, gone onto one of the pipes and got a reading. Then you reconnect it, okay, and then you go again. So let's look at what could happen then. Let's imagine second scenario. We've got disconnect our protective bonding conductor to here, okay. I've disconnected that protective bonding conductor and then I'm going to test to the other clamp. Okay, so I'm going to test it to the other clamp. So I'll come up and I'll test it to the other clamp just there. So now have I got a circuit? Okay, so I come down here. It's broken there and obviously we do not get a return path out. So all of a sudden now you're getting a little bit confused, aren't you? Because this one now hasn't got a reading. You had one previously, so if we go back here, we had a previous reading to here. Okay. Through here, and through to there. So we thought that one was continuous, but actually it was the gas one that we were measuring. And when we come back here, and we've got the one disconnected now, say to, I don't know, the water, whatever we're testing, we've got this one disconnected, and it's broken, and I haven't picked up a reading. So that becomes a little bit of an issue. So what you're thinking now is, hang on a minute, what if I go back and I test again? So you're panicking. So we bring it back in and you're thinking, right, okay, I'll disconnect and try again. So you disconnect and try again. So you put your lead onto here. Okay. And then you put your other lead onto here. You go back to this pipe. All right. So will I get a reading now? Remember, you can't see the cable runs. So I do, I get a reading. So that one's connected. And then, but I got a reading on this one. So if we go back to it, if we put that one back in again. Another lead. Let's put another lead as if I've done another lead there. Would I get that reading? So I've tested this one. I get a reading. And I just move my probe across to the other one, thinking I've got a problem here. I don't know what's going on. Would I get a reading? Well, I come through this pipe, work through the parallel earth path, and I get a reading. And you can see how easy under the pressure of an AM2, an AM2S, or an AM2E under the fault-finding one, you might think, well, I'm getting the protective bonding conductor continuous from this one, and I'm getting it from this one. So what's going on? How could you make that easier for yourself when you're doing that fault finding test? Well, it's easier to disconnect them from both ends, removing then the parallel earth path created here. So if I bring this one in, what we got now? So fault finding rig, I'm thinking about it. I've disconnected both. I'm going to carry out my protective bonding conductor test. I'll bring my first lead in. I'm going to put it on one of them disconnected. Okay, I'm going to disconnect it from the other end. So I'm going to need to remove it from here. So we're going to need to remove that connection just here. So we're going to take that one off and we're going to take that one off. By disconnecting them both from here, you remove this parallel earth path. So I'm going to test it to disconnected this end. So bring my other lead in, bring it around, and I there to my disconnected point. I prove that that conductor is continuous. I bring it round and that one is proved as continuous. If I disconnect this one here and I was to test here, you would find that that wasn't the conductor. You wouldn't have it at both ends. So if I left it on there, I tested there disconnected, no parallel earth path, it is also broken. So that would prove that one. If we bring the next one in and we disconnect it once again from the clamp, we disconnect it there and we disconnected both ends here and we bring our test leads in. Remember, we're going to test this one now. So we bring our test lead in and to our disconnected protective bonding conductor here in the fault finding rig, you would instantly find that that one is broken. You would find that straight away, that it comes through there and you have no reading. Again, if you were the opposite way around with them disconnected, you'd find you wouldn't have a reading, but that's what we've got. So we've got it disconnected under the fault finding one, removes the parallel earth path created here, which joined the pipework together. So as I said previously, when testing your protective bonding conductor for your newly installed cable, by all means, just disconnect it from the MET and test it to the clamp and the pipework. When you're doing your fault finding testing, disconnect it from the MET and the bonding clamp, because if there is a parallel earth path, you can start getting confused why the two sometimes get a reading on one of them, but both cables, and on the other one you don't get a reading. By disconnecting it at both ends and the fault finding element, you will find if they've, say, for instance, got a broken cable and an interconnection with a pipework creating a parallel earth path. It might be one of those videos, this end part, you need to watch a couple of times and really think about it. But I think when you're doing your endpoint assessment and the fault finding, disconnect them from both ends, your protective bonding conductor. And when you're testing your gas and water of your installed installation, just test it as we always have. Disconnect it at the MET, clip onto there, go to the clamp, go to the pipework, and prove the continuity of those conductors. Hope it's cleared up the video that I previously sent out. I was semi-right in it. It's probably here that you need to disconnect both ends and default finding. And as always, I hope this video will be some help.